people have to live in unity.
We are still in transition.
Civil society has been decimated.
Of course we rely on media.
And I think the government has not done enough.
The international community has failed to respond.
No place in the world is perfect. The
yoga event is held here.
Severe injustice and they should be stopped.
We should raise our voices.
Condemn this brutal act.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Shreya Savijay with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show with India, which has extended the world's biggest lockdown by 19 more days till 3rd of May. The government is taking a cautious foot forward in resuming the economic activities. Some sectors can reopen their operations from 20th April, but strict measures will require it to be followed. Meanwhile, it has ramped up its fight against the virus at multiple fronts. Have a look.
भारत में लॉकडाउन को अब 3 मई तक
इंडियन प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी अनाउंस्ड अ 19 डे एक्सटेंशन ऑफ द 3-week लॉकडाउन फॉर 1.3 बिलियन इंडियंस एज न्यू दिल्ली लुक्ड टू स्ट्रेंथन इट्स फाइट अगेंस्ट कोविड-19. द डिसीजन केम आफ्टर ऑल द स्टेट्स एंड एक्सपर्ट्स एडवाइज्ड द पीएमओ टू गो फॉर द एक्सटेंशन. First 3 weeks of lockdown had been successful at containing the spread of the virus, as the number of the cases were around 13,000 against over 800,000 predicted without lockdown.
साथियों, सारे सुझावों को ध्यान में रखते हुए ये तय किया गया है कि भारत में लॉकडाउन को अब 3 मई तक और बढ़ाना पड़ेगा. जो अपने यहां हॉटस्पॉट नहीं बढ़ने देंगे और जिनके हॉटस्पॉट में बदलने की आशंका भी कम होगी, वहां पर 20 अप्रैल से कुछ जरूरी गतिविधियों की अनुमति छूटछाट दी जा सकती है.
Although the numbers are small compared with hard-hit Western nations, health experts believe that there can be a sudden spike if the lockdown is lifted.
Social distancing.
The Prime Minister also appealed the nation to continue practicing social distancing and to take all the precautions required to combat the spread of virus.
सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग और लॉकडाउन का बहुत बड़ा लाभ देश को मिला है. अगर सिर्फ आर्थिक दृष्टि से देखें तो ये महंगा जरूर लगता है, बहुत बड़ी कीमत चुकानी पड़ी है, लेकिन भारतवासियों की जिंदगी के आगे इसकी कोई तुलना नहीं हो सकती.
गाइडलाइंस हैव बीन इश्यूड बाय द सेंटर फॉर द रिलैक्सेशन दैट विल बी ऑफर्ड टू सम एरियाज दैट हैव नॉट रजिस्टर्ड एनी केस फॉर अ सिग्निफिकेंट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. स्टेट्स हैव ऑल्सो बीन आस्क्ड टू टेक मेजर्स एंड डिसीजंस एज पर द रिक्वायरमेंट. Many states have successfully resisted the spread so far. The southernmost state of Kerala, which was the first region to witness COVID-19 cases in the country, is using information technology to trace contacts of coronavirus positive people. The techies are using geotags from a little control room in Alappuzha district civilian station. After tracing the contacts through route monitoring, they are making calls with interactive voice response systems to nearly 10,000 every day in Alappuzha district alone.
We had to follow up 10,000 people, nearly 10,000 people every day to know whether they are developing any symptoms or not. It's not possible to call each and every one of them every day and inquire for the development of symptoms. So we decided to implement the IVR system.
While on one side, the government is taking all possible preventive measures to stem the spread of the virus, on other, its departments are tirelessly working to flatten the curve, not just in India, but across the world. India has transported essential drugs to over 50 countries to fight the pandemic. Now, medicines will be sent in batches to these countries over a certain period of time based on when the order was placed by them and emergency situations in certain countries. While India has evacuated its stranded citizens from different parts of the globe, it has also been facilitating the repatriation of foreign nationals wanting to return home. India has received appreciation and gratitude for all the steps it has taken in the interest of humanity.
It is not only the Indian government, but the citizens too have overwhelmingly contributed in countries' fight against the coronavirus. While some have actively facilitated government's endeavours of providing the relief to the needy, others are hosting meals and recreational activities in order to cheer up the quarantined people. They have also launched awareness drives in different areas where they have been educating people of preventions, precautions and the disease. A report.
An artist in India's temple city of Bhubaneswar wore robes resembling iconic freedom fighter Mahatma Gandhi in a bid to raise awareness about the deadly novel coronavirus and to urge residents to remain indoors. He distributed masks and sanitizer to local residents, spreading the message to comply with social distancing measures.
तो रास्ते में हमको सिल्वर गांधी जी मिले वो हमें मास्क और सैनिटाइजर दिए और घंटी बजा के हमको जागरूक भी किए क्योंकि अभी तो चल रहा है कोरोना का वायरस बहुत ज़्यादा ही वो जो भी कर रहे हैं तो हमारे सेफ्टी के लिए ही कर रहे हैं
Artists in southern Chennai city painted a coronavirus themed graffiti on a road to generate awareness about the deadly virus and spread the message to stay home during the ongoing lockdown imposed to contain the disease.
இந்த வரவேற்கான காரணம் என்னவென்றால் தயவு செய்து இளைஞர்கள் சாலையில் வரவேண்டாம் நம்மை நம்பி நம்ம குடும்பம் இருக்கின்றது அதை மனதில் கொண்டு நீங்கள் வெளியில் வராமல் வீட்டிலே இருந்தால் வீட்டுக்கும் பாதுகாப்பு நாட்டுக்கும் பாதுகாப்பு
The integrated efforts of different government departments and private organizations have been bearing results as India has fared better and has successfully flattened the curve in comparison to other countries in Europe. People are also distributing food and essentials to the needy, while temple authorities in Western Nagpur city cooked food and fed the poor. The scenes were similar in India's northern Amritsar city, where food packets were distributed to workers.
Lockdown जब शुरू हुआ तब से लेके अब तक लगभग 1,00,000 plates का हम यहाँ से distribution कर चुके हैं. Average per day लगभग 5,500 लोगों का cooking हो रहा है.
In order to relieve stress and cheer the migrant workers. Regular yoga and other social distancing exercises are organized in different shelter homes across the capital, New Delhi. Authorities and private organizations are also ensuring that the spirit of the migrant workers and daily wages who have been highly affected due to the lockdown doesn't get dampened.
योगा से करने से मेरे शरीर में थोड़ी बहुत जहाँ भी जरकन शरीर में दर्द थी वो बिल्कुल कम हो चुकी है। और मनोरंजन के लिए मैजिक है, पूरे हफ्ते मैजिक थी, संडे को छुट्टी थी, बाकी दिन रोज़ मैजिक होती थी। और खाने पीने में अभी सुबह चाय के साथ ब्रेड या कभी बिस्कुट, नाश्ते में कभी समोसे, केले, सेब, संतरे मिलते हैं। दोपहर में चावल दाल सब्जी मिलती है और शाम के टाइम में पूरी सब्जी मिलती है।
New Delhi rolled out a multi-pronged plan to combat COVID-19 last week. It has been regularly upgrading both its medical and social tactics to contain the spread. State governments have been instrumental in enforcing the measures and ideas being suggested by the central leadership. The commitment of public towards the cause has so far shown that they have understood the gravity of the situation and do not want to relax even for a second in this huge fight against coronavirus.
Moving on, Pakistan is not just battling the coronavirus outbreak but also the medical threats emanating out of ignorance of the religious hardliners in the country. The country has hundreds of takers of the rumors saying that Muslims are immune to COVID-19 and only non-Muslims will contract the virus. These people who have a patronage of Islamic lobby have been regularly flouting the restrictions imposed by the government and are posing an even bigger challenge to the country, which is economically weak and medically ill-equipped.
A time when the numbers of coronavirus patients are multiplying every day, there are few who believe that they are immune to the disease and their God will find ways to protect them. Defying all the medical council and government orders, a number of people in Karachi are attending Friday prayers without masks and other precautionary measures. Vakas Ahmed says he offers prayers almost every day at a mosque where he says dozen or so men are in attendance. Ahmed is among thousands of devout Muslims flouting Pakistan government orders issued late last month banning religious congregation of 5 or more people to stem the spread of the coronavirus.
सबसे पहली बात ये कि अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह हम मुसलमान हैं और हमारा अकीदा अल्लाह पर है। और दूसरी बात ये है कि जो शख्स घर से वज़ू करके निकलता है, नमाज के लिए आता है, तो उसको अल्लाह की तरफ से कोई भी जो है बाबा कोई भी बीमारी नहीं होती सिवाय मौत के। और दूसरी बात ये है कि मैं मास्क और ग्लव्स इस वजह से पहन के नहीं आता हूँ क्योंकि मैं बावज़ू होता हूँ अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, और मुझे अल्लाह पर पूरा भरोसा है अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह। कोई भी शख्स अगर ऐसा अमल करेगा, हम सब मुसलमानों का इस बात पर अकीदा है कि जो भी शख्स जो है वज़ू करके घर से आएगा उसको कभी भी कोई भी बीमारी नहीं होगी सिवाय मौत के होगी।
The disease has so far infected more than 5,400 people and killed around 100 people in the world's second most populous Muslim country. In light of rising numbers, the country was forced to extend its lockdown by 2 weeks, but religious leaders, in an open defiance, publicly announced that mosques will continue to remain open.
इंशाअल्लाह ताला आज से मसाजिद पर लॉकडाउन का इतलाक नहीं होगा और लॉकडाउन की इस्तिलाह इस्तेमाल नहीं होगी, मसाजिद फंक्शनल होंगी। हाँ, इस बात की हमने अहद किया है कि जो सोशल डिस्टेंस का तिब्बी मशवरा है उसको मेंटेन किया जाएगा और मस्जिद में 5 वक्ता नमाज, जुम्मतुल मुबारक, नमाज तरावीह, एतिकाफ, तमाम इबादात का सिलसिला जारी और सारी रहेगा।
मोर देन 60% ऑफ द कोरोना वायरस केसेज इन पाकिस्तान हैव सो फार बीन लिंक्ड टू मुस्लिम्स, returning from pilgrimages in the Middle East, and followers of the Tablighi Jamaat, an Orthodox proselytizing group. But some people who have been deeply indoctrinated by religious fanatics have no regards for science, and they think coronavirus cannot touch them. While the Council of Islamic Ideology, a body that advises the government on religious issues, has called on clerics and the public to cooperate with government measures, several priests and local leaders have opposed the ban. The law enforcement agencies have appealed clerics to explain the gravity of the situation to the common public, and doctors are asking to put heavy restrictions on any type of congregations.
जुमे के दिन उससे पहले ही हम लोग पेश इमाम हज़रात से और मस्जिद की जो इंतज़ामिया हैं उनसे हम गुजारिश करते हैं, हम उनकी मीटिंग्स करते हैं, उसके बावजूद भी लोग पहुंच जाते हैं। तो वो जब लोग पहुंच जाते हैं, हम कोशिश यही करते हैं कि हम उन्हें समझाएं, उनको बताएं कि कोरोना वायरस कितना ख़तरनाक है और उससे ना सिर्फ उनको बल्कि उनके रिश्तेदारों को, घर वालों को, दोस्त अहबाब, मोहल्ले वालों को परेशानी हो सकती है। तो हम कोशिश करते हैं, समझाते हैं, और समझाने में अभी तक काफ़ी जगह कामयाबी हो रही है। कहीं कहीं ऐसे हालात भी पेश आए जहाँ लोगों ने हमारी बात नहीं मानी, क्योंकि ये मज़हबी मामला है, ये सेंसिटिव मसला है, तो इसलिए हम लोगों के साथ ज़्यादा सख्ती नहीं कर सकते।
A spike in the congregational prayers is the biggest worry and challenge for the authorities. Hundreds of them recently gathered without any hindrance at one of the city's largest mosques in capital Islamabad. On March 27th, authorities filed 88 cases against mosque administrations in Karachi and arrested 38 people for defying restrictions on Friday congregations, but charges were dropped a day later and the people were released.
Moving on, Bangladesh is having hard times in dealing with the growing pandemic. The garment workers in Bangladesh who have not received salaries and are left unemployed due to the shutdown of factories have taken to the streets. The garment industry of Bangladesh, which is the second largest in the world, has not been operating for days, and the uncertainty looms over its restart.
These workers who have blocked an important highway of the country are demanding their salaries to be paid. Bangladesh is a manufacturing hub of clothing and its factories have clients across the world, including the premier international brands. The retailers have either cancelled or paused their orders in the wake of spread of the novel coronavirus, prompting the owners to shut their factories, with hundreds of thousands becoming jobless. Many of the protesting workers, however, are complaining that it is not just about past 2 or 3 weeks, but they haven't received their salaries for the past few months.
এই অবস্থা, আমরা ঘরে চাল নাই, খাবার নাই, আমরা কি খাবো? ওই জন্য আমরা আস্তে আস্তে নামছি।
Bangladesh's crucial garment industry employs 4 million workers across some 4,000 factories. Garment exports accounted for $34.1 billion, or 84% of the country's overall exports in the fiscal year through June 2019.
চার মাস, 5 মাস ধরে বেতন পায় না। একে তো করোনা পরিস্থিতি, মাননীয় প্রধানমন্ত্রীর কাছে আমাদের আকুল আবেদন, আমাদের বিষয়টা বিবেচনা করুক, এবং মনে করেন এখানে যারা কাউন্সিলর আছে তারা আমাদেরকে চাল ডাল কিছু দিচ্ছে না।
Major retailers like H&M, Gap, Zara and Primark source their clothes partially from Bangladesh. Industry sources said earlier in April that some of the brands had cancelled orders, while some have stopped placing new orders. The Bangladesh Garment Manufacturers and Exporters Association reported that orders for over 900 million garments worth $2.9 billion has already been cancelled or were being held up.
যেই জায়গায় নাকি করোনা ভাইরাসের জন্য পাঁচজন একসাথে থাকা নিষেধ, সেই জায়গায় আমরা হাজার হাজার শ্রমিক আজকে একসাথে রাস্তায় নেমে দাঁড়াইছি কেন? এই বেতনের জন্য আমাদের।
Dhaka recently unveiled $588 million package for the country's export sector, asking companies to put the money towards paying workers. The country has witnessed a spike in the number of coronavirus cases last week. Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has extended the lockdown until 25th April to contain its fast spread.
Coronavirus has taken a toll on almost every aspect of people's lives. Whether it is food, clothing or recreation, everything has come to a standstill. The festivals have also been impacted, with people forced to offer their prayers inside homes and restricting their celebrations. Recently, people in Sri Lanka, India and Nepal observed their festivals in lockdown. Have a look.
Sri Lankans had a muted celebration of the Sinhala and Tamil New Year, as a lockdown and a work-from-home order have been imposed to help stop the spread of the novel coronavirus pandemic. In the capital Colombo, normally bustling streets were deserted, while shops that would have been packed with people buying gifts to family members and friends have been closed for weeks. The festival is celebrated by 90% of the Sri Lanka's 22 million population, marking the end of the paddy harvesting period.
Namut metek kalayak pavathi e charithraya ada apita dakinta nolabenne me loka vyaptawa pathire thiyena me covid 19 corona virus yat ekka eka koi tarang barapatalada kiyenawa nan koi tarang eka lokeyata danenada kiyenawa nan minissu eliyata yanne nathuwa visheshayenma රජයේ උපදෙස් පිළිපදෙමින් සෞඛ්‍ය අංශවල උපදෙස් පිළිපදෙමින් ස්වයන් නිරෝධායනයක යෙදලා තියෙනවා ගෙවල් දොරවල් වලට වෙලා ඉන්න තියෙනවා ඉතින් ඒක අපිට පේනවා මේ වසංගතය පැතිරී යාම වැළැක්වීම සඳහා ගත යුතු කළ හැකි එකම කාර්ය හැටියට
Normally millions will flock to Buddhist and Hindu temples to take part in religious activities however Buddhist religious leaders have advised the island's majority Buddhists to observe religious rites from home. Neighbors traditionally make and exchange sweets during the New Year celebrations, but many have been turning to food delivery companies for the candies. Police in Sri Lanka warned that people who violate the lockdown will be dealt harshly, as the government appealed people to celebrate the festival with their families at home. The celebrations of major jatras and festivals that used to draw thousands of devotees to holy places were called off, and only the ritualistic works were carried out in the Himalayan nation, Nepal. Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli sympathized with the people of the country, saying they were locked in a situation where nothing could be done except staying indoors.
वास्तवमा उल्लास र उमङ्गको पर्व हुनुपर्ने थियो समीक्षा र नयाँ सङ्कल्पको अवसर हुनुपर्ने थियो तर यस नयाँ वर्षलाई हामी साह्रै अप्ठ्यारो परिस्थितिमा स्वागत गर्दैछौँ
A few days back, temples wore deserted look in India, except monkeys being the only visitors on the occasion of Hanuman Jayanti festival. The festival marks the birth anniversary celebrations of Hindu monkey god Hanuman, who is considered to be very wise, strong and immortal.
हनुमान जी महाराज से हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि इस महामारी का जल्दी से जल्दी खात्मा हो और हमारे जितने भी श्रद्धालु हैं हमारे आराध्य हनुमान जी महाराज के जल्दी से जल्दी दर्शन करें और आप सभी लोगों से विनम्र निवेदन है कि अपने अपने घरों में श्री हनुमान जी महाराज का हमें से ध्यान और पूजा पाठ करें
India is a land of festivals, and the almanac has at least one festival every month.
The lockdown, however, has not been able to dampen the fighting spirit of people. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.